What's up, everybody? Welcome to another English Beat. Today, I'm going to challenge you with 5 new expressions that you're going to translate from Spanish into English. We've done the first edition of this quiz before, so if you haven't watched it, you can check it out right there. Are you ready for the new challenge? So let's get down to business. So, the first expression, how do you say in English, a bote pronto? Es decir, cuando decimos lo primero que se nos pasa por la cabeza sin pensarlo demasiado. Do you know the answer? So, in English, it would be off the top of my head. Por ejemplo, si yo le pregunto a alguien, ¿en cuántos países has estado hasta ahora? How many countries have you been to so far? Tú podrías decir, así a bote pronto, yo diría que unos 20. Off the top of my head, I'd say around 20. Okay, so let's move on to the second expression. Do you know how to say in English, me suena a chino? Cuando leemos o escuchamos algo que no entendemos, podemos decir, me suena a chino. So do you know how to say it in English? So there are 2 possibilities. You can say, it sounds Greek to me, me suena a griego. Or you can also say, it sounds double Dutch, me suena a doble holandés. So let's look at one example. Él explicó cómo funcionaba el nuevo programa informático, pero me sonó a chino. It would be, he explained how the new IT program worked, but it sounded Greek to me. Así que acordaros que en castellano decimos chino, mientras que en inglés podemos decir o griego o doble holandés. Así de curioso. Okay, let's continue with our third expression, which is más vale prevenir que curar. Do you know how to say it in English? Cuando no queremos correr demasiados riesgos y preferimos ser precavidos, we can use this expression. So, in English, we would say, better safe than sorry. So, for example, no me apasionan los deportes de riesgo. Es mejor prevenir que curar. In English, we would say, I'm not into risky sports. Better safe than sorry. So I hope you're doing it great at home. And our fourth expression is a la tercera va la vencida. Do you know how to say it in English? It would be third time lucky. Es decir, tercera vez con suerte. Por ejemplo, no te rindas. Seguro que aprobarás el examen la próxima vez. Como dicen, a la tercera va la vencida. So in English it would be, don't give up, for sure you'll pass the exam next time. As they say, third time lucky. And the last expression is, how do you say, soy todo oídos. Es decir, estamos muy interesados en escuchar lo que nos van a contar. Do you know how to say it in English? It's very, very similar. It would be, I'm all ears. Soy todo orejas. For example, cuéntame cómo fue la entrevista. Soy todo oídos. Tell me how the interview went. I'm all ears. So I hope you've got everything correct. If not, don't worry. Try to remember these expressions and use them next time you speak English. If you liked this video, thumbs up. Remember to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and see you in our next English Beat. Ciao for now!